Before they were known for gritty Misery 'em Up The Last of Us, Naughty Dog had already had quite the career. Starting as Jam Software in 1984, buddies Justin Rubin and Andy Gavin had already made a few games for the Apple II and Amiga. Changing their name to Naughty Dog, they managed to blag their way into a publishing deal with Electronic Arts after cold calling the tip line.
So we called the front desk, literally.
Following that, they began work on the game that would properly introduce Naughty Dog to the world, Crash Bandicoot. They were purchased by Sony in 2001, just ahead of their new franchise for their year-old console, the PlayStation 2. Jak and Daxter, the precursor legacy, launched in December 2001 and was one of the first platformers on the PlayStation that came anywhere close to the benchmark of Super Mario 64. The game took 3 years to make and really helped show off the power of the PlayStation 2. As impressive as Jak and Daxter was, its large world and seamless design was overshadowed by the monolithic success of Grand Theft Auto 3, launched a few months earlier in September 2001.
Grand Theft Auto set the bar.
2003's Jak 2 moves swiftly away from the lush green hills of the first game and throws you into the dystopian Haven City. You're no longer a fantasy hero. You're jacking cars, pulling jobs for crime lords, and blasting fools with a machine gun. Jak 3 followed a mere year later in 2004 and expanded on the gritty action world of Jak 2. Our plucky heroes have been banished into the wasteland and once again must save the world with guns, buggies, and leaper lizards.
I think you've been out in the sun a little too long.
While the trilogy may have wrapped up nicely, there was still some life in the series yet. It was high time Jak and chums got their own kart racer. 2005's Jak X Combat Racing wasn't just a racer. It packed a storyline about being poisoned, and racing was the only way to get the cure. It's a silly diversion, especially if you couldn't get your hands on Nintendo's Mario Kart. The Sony had also just released its first handheld, the PSP. And some former Naughty Dog employees helped create a spin-off title, Daxter. It's considered one of the best games for the platform. There was a second PSP title in development at Naughty Dog, but the team had moved on to create Uncharted. So development moved to high-impact games, and Jak and Daxter, The Lost Frontier, came out in 2009. As it came out 3 years after the PlayStation 3 had already launched, many gamers had moved on to new things, and the series was ultimately left behind. However, 11 years after the first game, the Jak and Daxter collection brought a HD remaster of the first three games to the PlayStation 3. The series has endured, with references being found in other PlayStation games, and concept art for a scrapped reboot showed up in a Naughty Dog art book. In 2022, the director of the Uncharted movie said he was working on a film based on the games, and apparently Tom Holland's interested.